What's in store for us today?
It's another bottom today.
I'll be 2 minutes.
And did those feet in ancient times walk upon England's mountain green? Don't worry, folks, you're in the right place. It's the Wednesday 20 show. And here's your host, Louise.
What did you have for breakfast that I didn't?
Tizer.
I need some of that. Goodness me. Calm down.
Okay. I'm so excited.
So today we have brought you to a beautiful place. It's called Velvet Bottom. Oh, another bottom. Who'd have thought it, eh? And today we're not going to one, not two, but three Wildlife Trust nature reserves on this walk. That's stunning, isn't it?
Oh, fab.
Three for one.
It's another one we haven't done, so... I'm so excited.
Oh, bless him.
I know.
Oh, so in order to find this, you basically need to drive up to the top of Cheddar Gorge. And where we crossed over the road a couple of weeks back when we did the gorge walk, there's just a little bit of lay-by there. So it's quite restricted parking, so get here early. And you basically come into the Black Rock Nature Reserve. You follow the path straight on ahead of you, and you'll eventually lead up into Velvet Bottom Nature Reserve.
You find yourself here first.
Yeah, this is still Black Rock, and I assume maybe named after the rock behind us. But funny enough, there's quite a lot of brown in that rock as well as black. But
well, hey.
Looks like there's been some recent rock falls. I wouldn't want to sit here when,
no.
When that lot's crumbling down.
Let's get our walking shoes on then.
Right, you ready?
Are you ready?
Okay.
Boots, get walking!
So what do you reckon is going to happen tonight then?
Haven't got a clue. It's so weird. Anything could happen.
Yeah. Well, we're talking about our favourite programme of the time. We're still watching Lost and we are addicted.
Well, truly addicted. We haven't watched terrestrial television now for weeks. We're just looking forward to our 2 episodes each night.
I know. Barry's mean. He only lets us watch 2. I'd quite happily sit there and carry on to 3, 4, 5 because I'm so hooked and I think about it in the night. I wake up and I think, oh, what's going to happen next? And then I'm talking about it in the day. But what's really spooky, there's been a couple of days I've said to Barry, hey, we haven't seen such and such for a while.
And then it happens.
And then it happens that night. And I'm like, that is spooky.
Witch. Do you know, it's just like watching a film. That's the way it is these days, isn't it? Instead of watching a 2.5 hour film, it's like you're watching bits of a film, night after night after night. It's just the way it is. Things have changed.
Yeah, I'm just glad we don't have to wait a week between episodes. I don't think I could cope.
No.
It's bad enough waiting 24 hours for the next bit.
It's funny, isn't it? Going back in your teens, can you remember the first film that you saw?
I think it was Watership Down.
Did you watch it alone or with your brothers or with your mum and dad?
No, I think my mum took me.
Oh.
And I think it was to make up for the fact that my brothers were taken to see the Star Wars, the original one, in 1977 it would have been. And I obviously wasn't allowed. Not that I knew what Star Wars was, but I remember being well and truly fed up that we dropped them and my dad off at this massive queue in Birmingham for this cinema that went right around the block to watch Star Wars, and I was really upset because I wasn't allowed to go because I was too young.
Oh, well, you would have been. You were only
5. But so I think Mum took me. It must have been, I don't know where in my memory, but it seems like it was around that time that we went to see Watership Down. And I remember crying. It was so sad.
I know, it is, isn't it?
There's little rabbit gets taken. But do you know what else struck me? I remember there being an advert for the Jaws film.
Oh, that's even worse. Take some of that.
I know. So I'm sitting there waiting for my first ever film, a nice fluffy thing, and there's like some advert for the
I was
terrified just hearing the music. Traumatised before the film started. Anyway.
Seeing we're talking about films, my first film was in 1957. That was the first one I saw. It was in black and white, and my parents took me to see Bridge Over the River Kwai.
It's a war film, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a war film. True, it's a true story. And I remember being so impressed with it. I really had a top score in my English literature class because we had to write a story. And I wrote about 15 sheets of A4 covering this story. And I read it out in class. Wow.
Did you use really big writing?
Probably. But I could just remember the film was so vivid. Back in those days, they had two films. They had an A film and a B film. The B film was shown first and then the A film. So it was great, wasn't it? And what we used to do, we used to get there about 10 o'clock. By about 1 o'clock, when it all finished, we go and get something to eat, like some popcorn or junk.
Happy.
And then we watch it again. You could sit in the cinema and watch it again. So we watched both films twice, watching four films. That don't happen anymore, does it? Nah.
Well, there you go. I think it's time for our first song.
Yes, please.
They don't know about us.
One, two, three, four.
In a nature reserve, honestly. You just can't.
Putting then, putting.
We've left behind the Black Rock Nature Reserve. It's about a half a mile stroll up through there, and now we've entered Velvet Bottom Nature Reserve. This place has got a history dating back through to Roman times of lead mining, and right up until Victorian times they were still mining here. And it's actually affected the flora that will grow in this area, and hence the name Velvet Bottom. Because of the amount of lead that still is in the soil around here, only certain things will grow. And you've got this very smooth looking kind of velvety kind of grass. I assume that's where the name comes from. Yeah.
Good explanation, love.
Yeah. As we walk up through, there's kind of various, it looks like old dams that go up through the valley. And apparently that dates back to in Victorian times, the way they separated the lead from...
Don't tell them that. We could tell them that in a minute, Louise. Oh, keep them on the edge of their seats. Come on.
Right, before I was rudely interrupted by Mr. Walsh, I was telling you a little bit of the history about these kind of dam-like structures as you walk up here. So there's about five, I think, in total, and it looks a bit like a wall in ahead of you, but as you get behind it, it's like another layer. It's like big steps. But originally, in Victorian times, these were built because they had caused a big problem. The way they separated the lead from all the other material was they kind of had a big ditch thing full of water, and they stirred it all up, and the heavy lead went to the middle, and the rest of it flowed away underground down towards Cheddar. But apparently it ended up killing all the fish and things, damaging all the water down in Cheddar. So they were forced to build these big dams in order to slow the flow of water and actually collect most of the lead before it went away and damaged everywhere else. Fascinating. And it's really hard to imagine this beautiful tranquil area as an industrial mining place, isn't it?
Doesn't time fly by?
Oh, I bet
it doesn't seem that long ago since you left school.
No, it doesn't. And then it shocks me to realise it's actually a while ago since my kids left school. How does that work?
30 years ago.
Oh, God, it probably is.
Woohoo!
How does that work?
Can you remember your first job?
Yeah, I got sacked from my first job within 2 days.
Sacked?
I was rubbish. I had a job as a barmaid at the airport tavern by the airport, but I was the shyest 18-year-old on the planet, couldn't do mental maths, couldn't bear it if anyone spoke to me. So the landlord, bless him, I don't know why he gave me a second day, to be honest, because I was terrible.
He probably liked the look of a young girl. He was probably desperate, love, in the way there wasn't anybody else that lived out by the airport tavern.
But he wasn't desperate
Only
enough
you.
To make
me. He still sacked you.
Yeah, he still sacked me after 2 days.
What was your second job?
So my second job was making the in-flight meals for the planes
up
at the airport.
That's a brilliant job, making the meals.
Yeah.
Can you remember, I used to love having a meal on a flight. I don't like flying, but the fact you can get up there and then you could smell food and they bring it around and they'd have your meal and then a pudding and then a wine. Oh, and then it was time to come down.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Did you enjoy that?
Well, it was kind of fun, but we did the cold meals, but there was like a formula you had to follow. So every meal, so you'd have like 360 plates laid out, and you had to put everything in the right place. So a tomato had to go here, the mayonnaise had to be piped in a certain way over here, and your lettuce leaf had to sit at 10 degrees to the, you know, it was very precise and everything had to look exactly the same.
Yeah.
And it was, yeah. After 360 flight meals, you were like...
You'd had enough.
Yeah.
Well, I could see you'd have salads in the summer.
And it was really early morning starts. We'd have to like start at 5 in the morning and things.
Wow. My first job was at Culver's Optional Wholesalers.
Mm.
And it was a job got me by my lifetime friend all the way through school, Philip Swift. Hi, Biffo. He's still around now.
I know.
Well, I am as well.
Yeah.
And it was where we used to make up frames for opticians. I didn't actually do it. I was just the boy that went to the opticians with the glasses that had been made up. They used to heat the frame over a Bunsen burner, grind down whatever lens they had, and then keep looking up to the light to see if it fitted, then put it over the Bunsen burner again and pop them in. That was the way it was done. Fantastic.
You should have kept that job. You could have saved us a fortune with a staff discount on glasses. They're so expensive, aren't they?
It was a job making Concorde that was calling me, love.
Oh yeah, let's not go there.
Let's talk about the wings again. Anyway, do you think we should get into our next song?
What a jolly good idea.
Fly away on our next song.
Which is called?
You can say.
Love Ain't With Me Tonight.
The wall is telling me the time, as the light of the day starts to fade. The tears in my eyes are leaving autographs, 'cause love ain't with me tonight. There ain't a sound in this old house of mine, the silence is calling so loud. My car's on the driveway, it don't wanna start, 'cause love ain't with me tonight. Love ain't with me, she's in a strange town, wearing her red dress and her high-heeled shoes. So I'm breaking down here with a broken heart, 'cause love ain't with me tonight. Shadows in a darkened room, I imagine I'm touching your face. I hold you close, but it's just a photograph, 'cause love ain't with me tonight. Love ain't with me, she's in a strange town, wearing her red dress and her high-heeled shoes. I'm breaking down here with a broken heart, 'cause love ain't with me tonight.
Velvet Bottom Nature Reserve, but we're now going to turn left out of the nature reserve and then work our way up towards the Lots, which is another nature reserve. So you'll get to a point and you'll see this big concrete slab that is obviously the foundations of an old building, not sure what, but at that point you're going to turn left to follow a track through a gate, well, a stile next to the gate, and you'll work your way up towards the farm and up towards the little lane and then on towards the Lots Nature Reserve. I can't help but notice that we've dug out the flask and biscuits. Woohoo! Do you love a biscuit?
Louise was telling me a story about how they make digestive chocolate biscuits.
Yeah, it was
I was fascinated by it.
It was,
tell them.
It was great. It was a TV program. It was one of these, like, inside the factory or something like that, and they were showing how they made it from beginning to end. But it was really interesting because, I don't know about you, but I've always assumed, you've got to have a chocolate digestive, haven't you? That you'd pour the chocolate on from the top. Wouldn't you have thought that?
Yeah, I would have.
But no, they don't pour it on from the top because then it would slide down and trickle over the sides, and they don't want the chocolate on the sides. So basically the biscuits travel along on this little wire mesh thing, like on a sitting on a river of chocolate. So they're all like floating along on this river of chocolate to make sure that you get a very even coating of chocolate on the bottom of the biscuit and not up the sides. Really interesting, isn't it?
It is interesting. They taste nice as well.
Oh, I love stuff like that.
But now, here comes the crunch. Do we dunk or do we not dunk? Do you eat them dry? Or do you like them soaking wet, like that? So much so they fall off and fall in. You've got to time it just right.
There's a science behind dunking. Now, I have to say, actually, it depends on the biscuit. I'm not a massive fan of dunking chocolate digestives.
Are you not?
No. If it was a ginger biscuit, or one of those Biscoff biscuit things, they are perfect for dunking. But chocolate digestives, no, I'm not a big fan of dunking.
Dunk it.
No, it's the wrong shape. No.
Break it in half.
No.
Anyway, I think at this point, we're going to move into our special guest this week.
What, we're moving in? Does she know we're coming?
She doesn't know.
Sorry.
And this week, it's Sarah McQuaid.
Sarah is a singer, songwriter and multi-instrumentalist from beautiful Cornwall. And we will let you see for yourselves the magic she weaves with her music.
Hello, I'm Sarah McQuaid. Thanks so much to Barry and Louise for inviting me to be part of the Wednesday 20 show today. And thanks to all of you for watching and listening. It's a lovely sunny day here in West Cornwall. Birds are cheeping outside and the tree branches are kind of scraping against the window in the wind. So if you hear that, don't worry, that's what it is. And as you can also probably hear from my accent, I am not from Cornwall originally. It's kind of a long story how I got here. So if you want to read it, you can go to the website, which is sarahmcquaid.com, and go to the About section and you can read up all about me and my history. And you can also read about the St. Burian Sessions, which is a new series of singles and videos that were filmed and recorded just up the road from here in the lovely old church of St. Burian. And I've been putting out these videos with these online premiere events, and it would be really nice if some of you felt like joining me for those and being part of them, and certainly checking out the videos as well. So again, all the info is on the website. But the song I'm going to sing for you now is not part of that series, so I'm really glad to have the opportunity to sing it for you. This is a song that I wrote about grief, which is something I know a lot of us are going through right now. It's called Only an Emotion. Since when? black anymore. We don't mourn, we don't talk about it, that's for sure. Smile like a bleeding children, and we swallow the pills prescribed. Does the power of our anguish has us terrified? Problem here to solve. It's natural. I'm feeling sad. That's all. And today I saw a funny thing that made me crack a smile. And the colors all seem brighter, and my songs get lighter. It just takes a little while. It's only an emotion. There's no problem here to solve. It's natural.
Oh, such a beautiful voice. I could listen to her all day, you know.
Beautiful, isn't it? In fact, Sarah, if you invite us down to your house in Penzance, perhaps we could spend a week down there and we'll cheer you all week because you're fab. And I know you're setting Britain on fire these days. You're beginning to turn heads. Well, you know that, don't you? And for all you people out there that is not aware of Sarah McQuaid, please check her out online because you won't be disappointed. Thank you once again for coming on our show.
Yeah, thank you.
Louise, when I left school in 1964, we had our own computers then.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I thought computers dated much more recently in our history than your era, darling.
Back in 1964, we had a printer. In 1964, we had a delete button. And in 1964, we had a refresh. See, and look what happened to us. We were intelligent and, irreplaceable. I know you kids are trying hard these days, but the class of 64, boom.
Yes.
About that.
Is that the best you can do?
That's the best I can do.
Right, time to move on then. Come
okay.
on.
Okay.
Just now, as we crossed a little footbridge, which was very pretty, wasn't it?
Oh, beautiful.
Oh, lovely little glade. And we came to the road. As we came through the gate to the road, we turn left, and then you walk up that little lane, just under a mile, and then you'll hear a stream coming down on your right-hand side, and there's a gate there. You turn right, and you follow the footpath up, and that's where we are again. And we've now turned left over the little stream, and we're now in the Lotts Nature Reserve. And we're going to follow that through. We're going to turn left again, cross back over the road onto the West Mendip Way, and continue on our journey.
Sounds a good plan to me, number one.
Yes. Come on then, number two.
Excuse me.
Who's getting up first?
Me.
Come on.
Louise.
Yes, what?
I thought of a game we could play.
What?
I thought of a game we could play.
Okay.
We'll have a game and we'll call it Tell Me When. And it starts off with a da 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 da. And I fire some questions at you and you tell me the year.
Oh, great.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. In this year, wait till I get to the end though.
Okay.
Wait, in this year, Marvin Gaye died. And in this year, Footloose was released by Kenny Loggins. And in this year, Careless Whisper was out in the charts. And in this year, Indira Gandhi was assassinated. Da 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 da. Tell me when, and the answer is
1983. 1984. Oh, one year out. I nearly said 84.
That's a good game, isn't it?
I don't like this game. Well, while I still carry on sulking about getting 1 year out on your flipping quiz thing.
Da 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 da.
Not again, no. Shush. I think it's time for you guys to have a look around where we are today.
Thank you.
we came down through Lot's Nature Reserve and we came back down to the lane that we had walked along before. As you reach that lane, you turn right, and then 50 yards along, you turn left here, and you can see this big long driveway into the distance. This is actually the West Mendip Way again. We've been on lots of bits of the West Mendip Way.
We have indeed.
Yeah, and this is going to follow all the way now back down to the Black Rock Nature Reserve where we started. Are you eating sweets and chocolate without me?
Just a bit.
How many has he just been eating? Oh, I don't know.
Munchies! Woohoo!
Honestly, you and your munchies, you're always munching. Come on, we've got, still got a way to go.
I've got shares. Louise has a confession.
I do.
Shame, the shame.
They look so happy about it. I made a bit of a mistake. At the beginning of our walk, I said we were going to go through 3 nature reserves. I lied. We're going through 4 nature reserves.
You didn't mean to tell a lie.
I didn't mean to. I completely forgot this last one and I'm very sorry to this Longwood Nature Reserve that I forgot it. But this West Mendip Way brings us down through the edge of Longwood Nature Reserve, which in bluebell season is the place to be. In fact, I remember this from my childhood. I've forgotten it. But now I know where I am, I've just recognised it, and it was my dad's favourite walk, and he always used to just call it Bluebell Wood. So, yeah, when the bluebells are back out, because we're too early for bluebells, we need to come back.
Come back and have a look. Mm-hmm. Although we've said that on a few walks.
We've got a lot of walks to revisit for the bluebells.
Are they out long, bluebells?
A few weeks, yeah.
Yeah? Yeah. A few weeks.
We could do 1 bluebell wood a week.
Do they stand up straight or do they begin to wither?
I think we all begin to wither after a while, don't we?
What are you saying? On that note, our last song time, I'm sure.
Mm.
Which is...
Pretty Flamingo!
Yeah!
1, 2, 3, 4...
Ready for me, no.
Okay, so we've come to the end of our little bimble today. We're at Black Rock again. We started here and we finished here. So we've gone on a loop. Where have we gone? We've gone Black Rock.
We went Black Rock through Velvet Bottom, through Lotts Nature Reserve, to Longwood Nature Reserve, and back to Black Rock Nature Reserve.
I've never done this walk before.
What did you think of it then?
I enjoyed it immensely. I feel as though I've been for a walk, although there's not any steep hills, only slopes and beautiful things to look at. We've looked at a little bit of rock face, a little bit of wood, the largest fields you ever did see, dry stone walls. We dropped our list of things to say and do. But we make it up as we go along. But at the end of the day, a thoroughly good day out. A walk good. We recommend. Well, we've come to the end. Time to go home and have some tea.
Excellent.
So, from Louise.
Bye.
And from me, thank you once again for supporting the Wednesday 20 show. See you next week.
Ready then?
Yeah. Put it on
it. It is on.
Is it?
It's always on.
All right. Right.
God, have you been drinking?
No. Go. Oh.
No.
Sorry.
Are you going to be like this all day?
I might be.
Someone help me.
Go on. I'm getting lost here.
You're lost. Lost. She's lost. We're talking about lost and he's lost.
Lost.
Lost. The wildlife that grows? No.
Wildlife can grow. You get big.
Take two.
Sorry.
And because of the levels of the lead in the soil, only certain grasses and...
turf. The sod. The sod.
Sodden. Sod.
No, that sod is soil in Latin, isn't it?
Oh, we have left behind the Black Rock Nature. Step up and it looks like a wall, but it's actually... Let's do zip noises behind the camera, shall we, Mr. Walsh?
Look at the size of that.
Zip. It's like someone's going camping. Do you want any more zip noises to go on while I'm doing this? Do you want to make any more noise?
All done.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Right.
Can you remember your...
And again.
Doesn't the time fly by, love? Can you remember...
Sorry.
Are you going to respond?
Yes.
Doesn't time fly by, love?
Yeah. Do I look a bit disinterested?
But I can remember my first job like I remember my first girlfriend.
What
you always remember your first anything, don't you? Wink, wink. What was your second job then?
My second job was I became a person who made the planes for made the plane.
Did you make any wings by any chance?
What is our next song?
Do you know, I cannot remember what our next song is. I've got it on a piece of paper down there, but I haven't got my glasses on.
What does it say?
Move on.
That's not our next song. So professional.
Oh dear. Do you dunk your biscuits or do you not dunk? That's the burning question. I mean, me, I'm really good at it. And I dunk them.
See, it depends on the biscuit. Chocolate dice.
Shit.
I'm so good at dunking, look at me. Oh, fabulous. You've got chocolate all over your moustache, do you know that?
Get it off, please.
Lick it off.
You lick it off.
Where is it? I think that's above and beyond a wifely duty.
Go. Nearly.
Ah, oh, is there whiskey in that coffee? Ow!
Fly!
Oh, Sarah.
A high ho, like silver this. Away!